Therefore I ask in which your only begotten Son went about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is praised with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month is to be the first of all others for you. This month of your year, speak to the whole community of Israel and say, on the 10th day of this month, each man must take an animal from the flock, one for each family, one animal for each household. If the household is too small to eat the animal, a man must join with his neighbor, the nearest to his house, as the number of persons requires. You must take into account what each can eat in deciding the number for their animal. It must be an animal without blemish, a male 1 year old. You must take it either a sheep or goats. You must keep it till the 14th day of the month, when the whole assembly of the community of Israel shall slaughter it between two evenings. Some of the blood must be then taken and put on the two doorsteps and the lintel of the house where it is eaten. That night the flesh is to be eaten roasting over the fire. It must be eaten with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. You shall eat it like this, with a girdle round your waist, sandals on your feet, and a staff in your hand. You shall eat it hastily. It is a Passover in honor of the Lord that night. I will go through the land of Egypt and strike down all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, man and beast alike. I shall deal out punishment to all the gods of Egypt. I am the Lord. The blood shall serve to mark the houses that you live in. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and you shall escape the destroying plague when I strike the land of Egypt. This day is to be a day of remembrance. For you must celebrate it as a feast in the Lord's honor. For all generations, you are to declare it a day of festival forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Like a hope of salvation, I will praise. I will call. servant, Lord, your servant am I, you have loosed my bonds.
Jesus said, no one who has taken a bath needs washing he is clean or permanent. You too are clean. Do not all of you learn. He knew who was going to betray him. And that is why he said, not all of you learn. When he had washed their feet and put his clothes on again, he went back to the table. Do you understand, he said, what I have done to you? You call me Master and Lord, and rightly, so I am. If I, then the Lord and Master, have washed your feet, you should wash each other's feet. I have given you an example so that you may copy what I have done. The Gospel of the Lord.
To lay down our lives for our brothers and sisters. To
wash others' feet expresses a desire to put ourselves first, to show them that they, no matter what society may come, love them as brothers and sisters in Christ. Imagine with what tenderness Jesus knelt down before each of his disciples, how he took their feet in his hands as if he was taking the chalice, how carefully he touched and kissed them to show them their dignity. By washing their feet, Jesus did not diminish his authority as their master. Rather, he was exercising authority in such a way that it touched the heart and built up trust. Jesus revealed the love of his Father in many ways throughout his earthly life, by healing the sick, multiplying bread, casting out demons, and proclaiming the kingdom of God. And then he showed the Father's love most fully at the hour when he passed from this world to the next, when he offered his life and sacrifice on the cross. And so, gathered here with his disciples in an upper room, he loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. He did this by means of two sacred actions, by washing the feet of his disciples, and then giving them his own body and blood. These two actions are woven together in the life of Jesus, and they can and should be woven together in our lives. For the past 2,000 years, whatever the followers of Jesus did, these two things in memory of him, the church has flourished, his gospel has taken root and produced good fruit. Failure, however, to wash each other's feet has led quickly to a decline of culture and to scandals that have scarred the beautiful face of the bride of Christ, the church. This twofold way of remembering Jesus keeps us from isolating what we do on Sunday from what we do on Monday and the rest of the week. It keeps us from segregating our prayer from our work, and from dividing our love of God from love of neighbor, and love of spouse and children. When the sacred scriptures are read in Mass, it is Christ who is speaking. When we receive Holy Communion, it is Christ whom we receive. And when we serve the least of our brothers and sisters, it is Jesus whom we serve. When Jesus washed the disciples' feet, he was engaging in a deeply Eucharistic act. He was making himself the servant of all. Let us love one another as Christ loves us. just have the prayers of the faithful. Sorry, Tony, I prompted you to do it. Let us stand.
One night before his death, Jesus sat at table with his disciples, gathered to reenact the sacred supper, and asked John the Christ and prayed to the Father for all our needs.
For the church on earth, that we may be guided to a greater understanding of the perfect love and service of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
For the Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of power and influence in the world, that they may understand something of the spirit of Christ's sacrifice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those confronted by temptation, that they may be strengthened by Christ's example of loyalty to his Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us in this community, that more and more we may reflect in our lives the Eucharistic love of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the dead, that the sacrifice of the Eucharist may bring them to eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we come before you and present our needs to you, humbled by the Eucharistic love and generosity of your Son, our eternal Spirit, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
the mountain. Good man, Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Simon and Jude, Dennis, Pinchas, Finn, Sextus, Cornelius, Sidney, Lawrence, Chrysogenus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Jamie, and all those things. We ask that through their merits and things, we may be defended by your protecting help through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service that we will offer, for our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and accounted among the flock of those you have chosen. We pray to God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve his offering in every respect. May it be spiritual and acceptable. So that this way may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread, and hold and took bread in his holy and beautiful hands, with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing. Broke the bread and gave it his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Gracious, and grant some share of fellowship with the holy apostles and martyrs,
Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look, my